Hello students, welcome to my channel. So dear students, in this class just we are going to discuss about growth and development. As you we had already discussed about the basic concept of psychology in the previous class. So in that class just we are going to discuss about what is growth and what is development and what are the difference between growth and development, and next we are going to discuss about the detailed stages of child development. So without let we are going to start the class. That is the major difference between growth and development. Major difference between the growth and development. First of all, growth is a physical aspect. Growth is a physical aspect and development is a physical as well as mental aspect. It's a physical aspect. Physical aspects. But development is a physical as well as mental aspect. Next point, growth is a quantitative process, but development is a qualitative process. It's a quantitative process, but development is a qualitative process. It's a qualitative process and growth is a quantitative process. Next point says that growth is a periodic activity. It's a periodic activity. It's a periodic activity. But development is a lifelong process or a continual process. It's a continual process. Continual process. Development is a continual process and growth is a periodic process. Why it is called periodic process and why it is called a continuous process? Because it continues throughout life. That means it starts from womb and ends at the tomb. But growth will be stopped whenever maturity will come. Whenever maturity will come, the growth will be stopped. So it will be stopped. It will be stopped after the maturity, but it's a womb tomb process. It's a womb tomb process or a lifelong process. Once again, in clear manner, first point is the growth is a physical aspect and it's a physical as well as mental aspects. Then after, it's a quantitative process, it's a qualitative process. It's a periodic activity, but development is a continual process which continue throughout the life, that starts from womb and ends at the tomb. And it will be stopped after the maturity. Whenever maturity comes, the growth will be stopped. Hope you clear about the concept, the major difference between growth and development. So dear students, now we are going to discuss about the detailed stages of child development. So first point is prenatal stage. Prenatal stage. In this stage, the fetus will create in the mother's womb, or it can be say the fetal stage. It is otherwise says that fetal stage. That means the fetus creates from the mother's womb. From creation of a fetus to the till birth, that period is called as prenatal stage. One much more important question related to that stage, most of the times that question is seen in your exam paper, that is the development starts from which stage. The development starts from which stage? That is prenatal stage. That is the development starts from prenatal stage. That question is very, very important for your upcoming examination, and most of the time that question seen in your exam paper. Hope you clear about the concept. So next we are going to start the next stage, that is infancy stage. That stage is infancy stage. That is the second stage of child development. Infancy. That stage holds the age factor, that is 0 to 2 year. According to Jean Piaget, we can say this stage is the sensory and motor stage. Why it is called sensory and motor stage? This is called sensory and motor stage. Sensory and motor stage, the infancy stage is called sensory and motor stage because the child can express their thoughts by utilizing the different sense organs. Because this stage is otherwise called as the stage absence of language. Absence of language stage. Absence of language stage. That means child is incapable to deliver the language in this stage. Only he or she can deliver the thought process or the thinking process or show their emotions by utilizing the different senses. It is also called the imitation stage, deferred imitation stage. It is called the imitation stage. Why it is called the imitation stage? Because the newly born child always imitate to other. That means he or she may imitate to others, then he or she may be capable to express their mental process, express their thought, express their feelings. So it is called imitation stage. First of all, infancy stage holds the age factor 0 to 2 years. Then it is called the sensory and motor stage according to Jean Piaget, because the newly born child can express their thought by utilizing the different sense organ. Next, it is called the absence of language stage because newly born childs are incapable to deliver their language. Otherwise, it is called the imitation stage. That is called infancy stage. Hope you clear about the stage of infancy. Next, we are going to discuss about the another stage, that is the third stage of child development, that is childhood. Childhood stage. It's a very, very important stage for the child development period, that is known as childhood stage. First of all, the childhood stage holds the age factor, that is 2 to 12 year. The age factor is interrelated to each other steps, because firstly we are going to discuss about the prenatal stage. Prenatal stage is called conception to birth stage, from conception till birth. Then after, we are going to discuss, already we had discussed about the infancy stage. Infancy means 0 to 2 year, that means till birth to 2 year. Then it also interrelated to infancy stage, that is infancy ends at 2 years and childhood starts at 2 years of age and ends at 12 years. Dear students, here childhood is further divided into two types. One is early childhood, another one is later childhood. What are the difference between early childhood and later childhood? Firstly, early childhood is called as preschool age. The other name of early childhood is preschool age. Like that, later childhood is called as school age. So it is otherwise called as pre-gang age. Whereas the school age is the school age or the later childhood is called as the gang age. It is called as the infancy stage. Sorry, it is called as the toy age. It is called as the toy age, whereas the later childhood is called as the troublesome age. It is called troublesome age. Dear student, in the tricky manner, just you remember, childhood is a rapid stage. It is called a rapid stage. Why it is called a rapid stage? Because the language development is rapid in the childhood stage. Human can learn the language, human can develop their language rapid manner in childhood stage. Also, socialization occurs in a rapid manner in the childhood stage. So that each and every activity happens in the human beings, that should be grow in a rapid manner. That's why it is called rapid stage. Hope you clear about the childhood stage. Another one difference between early childhood and later childhood is, in case of early childhood, humans or newly born childs are egocentrism, so they are egocentrism, or childs are egocentric in nature, but in case of later childhood, he or she may be less egocentric in nature. This is all about the childhood stage. So next we are going to discuss about next point, that is adolescence. That is the fourth stage and the end stage of child development, that is adolescence period. That stage is called as adolescence stage. That is the fourth stage, adolescence stage. As you know, the early childhood is divided into two types. One is 2 to 6 years, another one is later childhood, that is 6 to or 7 to 12 years. So adolescence starts from 12 to 19, or some books say 11 to 19 years. This is period called as the adolescence period. We can say adolescence is a bridge period. It is a bridge period. That means it creates a bridge in between childhood and adulthood. It creates a bridge in between childhood and adulthood. This is called adolescence. So this is called a bridge period, or called a transitional period in between childhood and adulthood. This is called adolescence stage. In this stage, the human or child can grow their sexual urges, and also this stage is called stress and storm stress. According to the psychologist A.G. Stanley Hall says that it's a period of stress and storm. This stage is called as stress and storm, according to the A.G. Stanley Hall. Once again, adolescence period holds the age factor, that is 12 to 19. It's a transitional period in between childhood and adulthood, because it creates a bridge in between childhood and adulthood. That means it creates a relationship, it establishes a relation between childhood and adulthood. This is the middle period, or we can say it is a golden age of life. Golden age of life. Very, very important question. Adolescence period is called as the golden age of child development, or golden age of human life. That concept was given by, it's a stress and storm stage, by A.G. Stanley Hall. Next, we are going to discuss about the most intense and crucial socialization occurs. The most intense and crucial socialization occurs in the stage of adolescence. That is the most intense and crucial socialization occurs in this stage. Hope you clear about the point, that is adolescence. So firstly, in a schematic manner, just we are going to discuss about the whole class. That is, first of all, we are going to discuss that is what is the difference between growth and development. Then the detailed stages. The first stage is prenatal. Then after, we are going to discuss, already we have discussed about the infancy. Then childhood is further divided into two types. One is early, another one is later childhood. Then also we are going to discuss about the adolescence, and you know adolescence is the last stage of child development. Except adolescence, there are also another stage, that is adulthood. Adulthood holds the age factor, that is from 19 to onwards. That means 19 to till death period is called as adulthood period. But some book says that, some data says that, that is adulthood is the 19 to 45 or 65, but that's a wrong concept. Adulthood is a period that holds the age factor 19 to end of the life. So dear students, this is all about the today's class. Hope you enjoy the class. If the class will be helpful for your upcoming examinations, then kindly subscribe the channel and also share the video. That's all. Thanks to everyone.